for me. I ain't talking about the shiggy.
Alright, what's up YouTube? Back again with another tutorial video. This time I'm going to show you how I do the animated photos effect like you saw in the clip at the beginning. It's actually kind of straightforward. There's nothing very complicated going on. All you need is Photoshop and After Effects, and you should be able to use it to do some really cool stuff. So let's do this. Okay, so the shot that we're going to be breaking down is this one here of Dappy at Strawberries and Cream Festival. I think this is a good example because there's quite a lot going on. You can see all these different hands at the front. But the way this is done is very much the same for every shot. So it could be this one here, or it could be this one. They're all pretty much the same. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna load up the base image into Photoshop, which is what I've done here. And this is the background image that we're gonna work with. Everything comes from this one still. And the first thing we need to do is we're gonna chop out all the different elements that we're gonna animate, and we need to put them on different layers. So the good thing about this image is because you've got all of these different hands, there's lots of elements to chop out, which also means in the final product, you're going to have lots of motion and there's going to be lots of things on different layers, which is going to look cool. So the easiest way to do it is probably using the quick selection tool. And this works really well when you've got a clear edge surrounding an object. So I can select his hat here and I can select his hand. I can just sort of go along the microphone like that. Keep going. So to select all of his body like this. It seems to be good. It seems to be picking up the edge quite neatly. So we'll do that. We'll include this blue hand and come down here. And then what I'm going to do on the layer zero here, which is the background, is I'm going to click this button here, which means create a new layer mask. And you can see straight away we've chopped him out. It's not perfect. There's a few bits that are wrong, like here. So what we're going to have to do is go into the layer mask, which is this bit here, this black and white area. Basically, anything that's white will still be visible. Anything that's black will be invisible. That's what a layer mask does. So you can see we've got rid of the Nike. We're going to need to bring that back. So I'm going to need to paint that in as being, I need to paint that in as being white. So there it is, that's back. Likewise here. So I'm just using a brush here with a nice hard edge to give me this edge back. And then we're also going to need to bring back, oh, there's some of the face there that's missing. We're going to need to bring back this area as well. So I'm going to go back to the main layer. I'm going to go quick selection tool. I'm just going to select this white area. And then we'll go back into the mask and we're going to paint it out. Oops, we need to be black now. So you can see it takes a bit of time, but what you need to do is sort of painstakingly cut out all of your characters. Get every single individual element that you're going to animate on a separate layer, otherwise this whole technique won't work. Okay, so what we're going to do next is we're going to chop out his arm because I want to animate the arm separately. And the way I'm actually going to do that is using the pen tool here, because there's not going to be an easy way of quick selecting the arm from the rest of his jacket. So we're just going to have to draw around it like this. I'm going to do this quite roughly, but you could obviously make it much more neat. Okay, so that's completed now. It was a little bit rough. You probably want to make it neater, but it'll be fine for this version. And then you're going to right click with the pen tool selected and you're going to go make selection, feather radius 0, and then hit OK. And then you're going to go select inverse. Now it's going to select the arm itself. And then we're going to go onto the marquee tool up here and you're going to go right click and then layer via cut. And what we've done is we've made a new layer here. I call that Dappy Arm. And that has chopped out the arm from the rest of his body. So that's what we need. But the problem is, of course, the body is now missing this big hole. So we're actually going to use Content Aware Fill to fill in the place where the arm used to be. And you'll see why that's important in a bit. So I'm going to go back onto the arm layer. I'm going to select with the Magic Wand tool. So that's selecting everything. Press Control Shift I, which basically inverts the selection. Turn off the arm, and you can see we've got the space where the arm was now selected. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to expand that selection just a little bit because the edges aren't perfect. And if I was to just fill this hole, there'd be like a white line along the edge, which is not what we want. Going to go back to the Dappy body layer, select, modify, expand. Let's expand by, 3 pixels should be fine. And you can see now this is over the edge and it's going to overlap, which is great. And then this is the genius bit. This is what makes the whole thing work. Edit and then content aware fill. And Photoshop, you can see, just magically fills in the gap of where his arm used to be. Okay, so we can hit OK. It's not perfect. You can see the Nike thing is actually all over the place, which is not necessarily what we want. So I might just Control-Z that. go back into the content aware fill, and then I'm going to deselect the Nike bit from the area. So you can press minus here, you can click on that, and now it's not going to sample that Nike logo. And yeah, you can see it's a little bit nicer. I mean, it's not perfect, it doesn't matter too much. So what we've got now is we've got this kind of like fake arm layer, which is meant to blend in with the jacket. We're going to put that underneath the body like that, Command D, and that's going to deselect everything. And if you zoom out, you wouldn't really notice that there's anything wrong. What we might do actually is we might just paint over this bit here because it looks a bit dodgy. Anyway, so you can see we've got Dappy's body, we've got this extra bit of arm that we've just filled in here. So let's merge that with Dappy's body. And then we've got the real arm, which is this. Do you know what? I think actually what I need to do is I need to get rid of a bit of the body underneath where the hand would be, because that's not realistic. So let's whack another layer mask on it here. We'll just scrub that out using a brush. There we go. That's more realistic. That's what his body would look like if his hand wasn't there. Because that's kind of what we're trying to create. We're trying to create the effect of what his body would look like if his hand wasn't there. And now if I turn on the hand, there we go. We're in a good place. Anyway, the way that this effect works is you basically need to chop out all of the different elements that you want to animate. So in this one, we want to animate the hand, and then you need to reconstruct what is underneath it. So I'm not going to go into too much detail. I'm just going to turn off the layer that I've just created and go back to the stuff that I'd already done. What I'm going to show you is the bits that I chopped out to actually make the edit itself, because I've got them here in the Photoshop layer. So I'm just going to delete this layer and delete this layer. Turn back on the background. So what I did is I also chopped out some of these phones that you can see in the foreground. So let me just show you all the individual layers. Turn off the background again. So that's the hand that we just saw. And then this is the body layer, and you can see I've reconstructed where the hand was in the same process using content aware fill. And then this layer, that's another phone. This layer, that's another phone. And this layer is another phone. Cool. The other thing we need to do is we need to reconstruct the whole background underneath where all of these items are. So all of my things are in this group here. Let me just turn them all on again. Turn that background layer off. You can see everything that we've chopped out. I'm going to duplicate this by pressing Command J. And then I'm going to merge the whole group. So I've got all of the items that I've chopped out on one layer. And then we're going to use the magic wand tool. We're going to select the kind of white stuff. She's going to turn contiguous off. There we go. So now we're picking up all of the stuff that we've chopped out. I'm going to press select and then inverse. So this is selecting all the stuff that we've chopped out. I'm going to make my selection just a little bit bigger because the edges aren't always perfect. So select, modify, expand, let's make it 5 pixels bigger. Okay, cool. So now we've got a nice selection around all the items that we've chopped out, and we're going to go back onto our background layer, turn this on again, and you can see actually the selection here around all these objects. And we're going to go edit content aware fill, and what this is going to do is it's going to rub out Dappy, it's going to rub out all of these phones and all of these hands and give us like a nice clean background layer. Okay, hit okay. Awesome, so that's what we need. Press Command D to turn that off again. So what we've got, I don't need this layer anymore, I just need the individual elements, is we've got this background layer here, which it looks a bit mucky and a bit weird, but it doesn't really matter because once we start doing the animation, all of these layers and all of these things will sit on top of the kind of dirty, weird, duplicated background thing. But when we start to move around, we'll be able to see a little bit behind the phones and we'll be able to see behind Dappy. So that's why we need to have this background layer without any holes in it. So what you're going to do is you're going to save out all of these separate layers. So the background, save it as a JPEG, call it background. These layers, we're going to save them as hand.png. And the reason we do it as a PNG is because if I just go into the place that I've saved all of these body bits, which I think I've called body bits. Yeah, there we go. Dappy. Blue hand. Dappy. Green hand. Hand. You can see that they have the transparency around the edges, which is also really important. If you did it as a JPEG, it wouldn't have transparency. So that's why you got to do it as a PNG. And this is it. These are all the things we need to make this animation. So we've got iPhone, hand, hand, green hand, Dappy, blue hand, background. Cool. And all those things together will make the scene. Okay, so here we are in After Effects. This is actually the final composition that made it into the edit. So I'm going to break down everything that's going on and show you exactly how this came together. So let's make another one and I'll show you what's going on. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to take background.jpg. We're going to drag that here into new composition. Composition settings, let's set this to 1920 by 1080. Duration, zero. Let's make it five seconds long. I think that's good. Okay. And then we're just gonna need to drag in all of these elements. So now we've got these layers in, what we need to do is we need to turn them all into 3D layers. I'm gonna press this button here, and then I'm gonna go new camera. And this is how we create the kind of 3D movement using this camera. If you don't know anything about After Effects cameras, you're gonna learn a lot in the process of this video. So the first thing we need to do with the camera is we need to go auto orient and then off. And this is gonna enable us to move it around freely in space. And then I'm gonna hit P and I'm gonna just move this back so we can see everything. And then what we need to do is we need to position all of our layers at different depths. And we're gonna create that kind of 3D movement using this technique. So background, this needs to be further back. So I'm gonna hit P. Anyway, so the bigger this number is, the further back it is. So let's put it at 4,000 to start with. So you can see it gets smaller if we do that. So what we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to scale it up as well. So hit S. And then just scale it back up to the size of the frame. So what we don't want is we don't want to be able to see these weird bits of content-aware fill that we've got, like here. So I think it looks like about 146. Yeah, that seems to work. And then what you can do is you can press two views and you can see the different layers. So this is all my other stuff. And then this is the background. You can see much further ahead or further away. And then this over here is our camera. And if we move the camera around like this, you can see the camera moving in and out. And straight away that you can see if I do this, the background moves at a different speed to the foreground, and you've already got that kind of 3D perspective, which is what brings this effect to life, because we've put the background layer further back and the rest of the stuff in the foreground here. Anyway, let's go back to one view and start positioning the other elements as well. So Dappy, I'm happy with him on zero. Hand just needs to be a little bit further in front, I think. So let's put the hand at minus 100, and if the number's negative, it comes closer to the camera. Cool, and then green hand is gonna be minus 1,000, so it's even closer to the camera. You can see it's this hand here. And then blue hand, let's put that as minus 1,500. So it's coming even closer. And then, what's my third thing? Oh yeah, iPhone. That is gonna be minus 2,000, so it's gonna be even closer to the camera still. And now, if I go into my two views, you can see all of these different layers are positioned at different points in 3D space. So the camera is gonna kind of pass through them as it moves towards Dappy in the center. So let's create that move. And this is kind of the fun bit. This is when we're gonna start animating. So I'm gonna hit P on the camera layer position. And then I'm gonna go 5 seconds later and I'm gonna zoom in by just changing that property there. And let's end up on his face as well. So we're gonna move it up a little bit like that. There we go, that's cool. In fact, we can start even further out. Let's zoom out even more to start with. Cool, and now if we play the animation through, you can see we're kind of passing through all these different layers and we've got that kind of 3D perspective already. And that's pretty much all it is. That's pretty much the entirety of this effect. The other thing I might do is I might add a bit of rotation as well. So let's add like 10 degrees of rotation, maybe even less, what about 5? And then we're gonna come to the end, hit U just so it lines up with the other keyframe. And I go -5 on the rotation there. I'm also just gonna start a little bit higher up so we see these hands and we're gonna pass through them a bit better. Cool, so now if we play this through, you've got this cool 3D move and you can see the phone's coming closer to the camera and it really feels like we're zooming through space, getting closer to him. The other thing we need to do is we need to add just a small amount of movement to all of these objects, because when you add a tiny bit of movement, it feels like you've been filming this on like a slow-mo camera and it's got this like really insane kind of like frozen time effect, whereas when it's static it just feels quite boring and quite dull. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a bit of rotation onto his hand, which is in the foreground here. That's this one here. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it rotate around the elbow like his hand normally would. So you can hit Y and that's going to move the anchor point, which is this thing in the middle. We're going to put that where his hand would rotate from, and then we're going to hit R to bring up orientation, keyframe that. So let's just add maybe, yeah, let's add like 4 degrees to start with and then go to the end, and then we'll bring that down to like -2. So you can see the hand now is slowly moving down throughout the course of the shot and it just feels like it's moving in slow motion. I think we could have even more than that, to be honest. Let's start with like 10. So there's actually gonna be quite a lot of movement of this hand. So now, yeah, there's quite a lot of movement. I think that looks really cool. It looks like we're zooming in and he's moving in super slow motion, but the camera's moving super quick. And then the other thing we're going to do to bring him to life is we're going to use the puppet warp tool, which is this one up here. I don't know if you've ever used this or not. If not, then it's a good time to learn. And what this does basically is you define different points on his body, and then you can move them around and have them kind of animate as well. So let's just click as if he was like a kind of wireframe human where he would have joints as normal. So let's put one in the elbow, let's put one in the shoulder here, put one in the hand, maybe one in the head, one in the neck, and then one over this back shoulder, one in his waist, and then one down here. This creates a mesh. In fact, I can click show mesh and you can see the kind of points that it's created. And then we can kind of drag these points around and literally move him like a puppet. And that's how we're gonna create another level of kind of motion. That's way too much movement, so I'm just gonna control Z that. And then let's go to the end. And then let's just add a little bit of movement into this elbow. So it's as if he's raising his hand. You can see it looks like he's kind of raising his hand. So maybe just like rock his head back a little bit, bring his shoulder up. Let's move around. Let's move the waist in a little bit as well. So it just kind of feels like he's moving just a little bit. I mean, that's what we're using the puppet engine for. So you can see with a little bit of puppet movement, it just feels like he's moving in slow motion. You've got this really cool kind of frozen time effect. Combine that with the hand and it actually feels like we've shot this on like a Phantom Flex 1000 frames per second camera. The other thing I would do to this as well is I would add a bit of movement into these foreground hands. So let's say blue hand, this one here, I'd probably just have that come up just a little bit over the course of the shot. So if we start there, and then maybe 4 seconds in, let's just bring it up like that. And then we're adding another position keyframe here. So you can see that hand's gonna be moving just a little bit as well. And it all just adds to the effect. And that's pretty much all there is to it. The other thing you're gonna wanna do quite soon is you're gonna go into your camera, you're gonna go camera options, and you're gonna turn depth of field on. Because what we probably want to do is we want to blur out the background. We've got a couple of these kind of messy patches that we've created. So we can fake kind of depth of field to also enhance this effect. So the two things we need to care about are focus distance and aperture. I'll turn keyframes on for both of them. I'm going to knock the aperture up to about 500. And you can see straight away that we've got like a much shallower depth of field now. We've got the hands kind of in focus, which is not what we want. We want Dappy to be in focus. So let's just move the focus distance back until he becomes sharp again. Yeah, so it looks like at about 9,000 pixels, he's nice and sharp. And then if we go to the end, he's gonna be nearer than 9,000. So let's try 3,000. Yeah, so at 5,000, he's nice and sharp. So hopefully as the camera moves in, the focus will change with it. So you can see now the focus is moving as he moves throughout the course of the shot. And you can see at the end there, he's nice and separate from the background. And it really feels like we've got this kind of slow motion push in, which is exactly what we wanted. So that's pretty much it when it comes to animating a photo in the same way that I've done it. And if you want to just mess around at this point, then that's pretty much all you need to know. But I've done a few other things in this clip. Like you can see, we've got the text animating. We've got these kind of cool background flickers going off. And then we've got the flashes of the cameras going too. So there's a couple of other things that I'm going to show you. But for that, I've done another video. So you just click through to part two and keep watching if you are still interested. But if you're not, then hit like, hit subscribe, tune back in again for the next tutorial. Got plenty more things that I want to share with you very, very soon.